This is so hard today.
I'm so hungry.
Oh my gosh.
Can I get some food after this?
Dibs.
I guess we'll see who gets there first.
Dude.
Hey Stacy.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. What are you doing this weekend?
Just chilling.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, do you like cheese?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, how's the competition going? You talked to Stacy yet?
I don't really want to talk about it.
Okay. Whatever.
Hey, Stacy, what are you doing this Friday? You coming to the football game?
Yeah, I am.
All right. Well, I mean, you know, I'm going to be playing in the game. So if you want to come hang out with the star player on the team at my house after the game, you know, you can come over like maybe like 11.
Sounds great.
All right. I'll see you on Friday.
Bye.
Bye. See ya.
Ben, I saw you talking to Stacy earlier.
Yeah,
I mean, I really like her, and I, like, genuinely care for her.
I mean, sorry, bro. I didn't know that there was, you know, any problems here, but maybe you should communicate a little better.
I mean, it just doesn't even sound like you care, so whatever.
Hey, boys. I've been noticing that there's a lot of tension between you two at practice, and I've been thinking about any possible solutions that you guys might be able to come up with, and I think you guys might need to take some time apart from each other, because, I mean, it is really your ally here, and if you guys detach yourself from all the emotions, you guys might be able to really think back about all the good times you guys used to have. Because, I mean, I've seen you at plenty of practices being happy and whatnot, and I know you guys can get back to that.
Yeah.
All right, we'll do that. Thanks, Coach.
Hey,
oh,
I was wondering
coach.
If you could maybe stop by my office after lunch so we could talk about some things.
Yeah, I can do that.
Perfect. After lunch, I just wanted to take some time to hear about your perspective on what's going on with you and Jack.
Yeah, I mean, Coach, you know, Jack has been really distant from me lately, and he seems so upset all the time, but whenever I ask him what's wrong, he just says nothing and blows me off. I don't really want to pry too much, so I just assume he'll tell me when he's ready, but he told me he liked this girl, and I figured we'd make a game out of it to see who could get her first, but I think he's just mad at me for winning the competition. I always win, so he shouldn't act too surprised.
Well, to me, it actually sounds like that you never want to intentionally hurt Jack. Blind spots in life are similar to the ones in football, actually. It's hard to see all around you when something's blocking your way. Taking accountability for how you make others feel will help get rid of those blind spots.
Yeah, I think so. Maybe.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
I just wanted to see what your perspective is on you and Ben.
Okay, yeah, I mean, Ben's always been a really good friend to me, but lately our friendship has been different, and I feel like he's taking me for granted. I never used to mind letting him be the star of the show, but lately it's like he wants to prove he's better than me or something. He knows I'm not very confrontational, so he should also know that when I'm mad, I get distant and really annoyed. To top it all off, the other day I told him I liked a girl, and he made it into a competition to see if he could get her first. He knows I'm shyer than him, so why can't he treat me the same way he treats other people for a change?
I understand how easy it is to become vulnerable when bringing up a conflict, but vulnerability is actually a factor of confidence. I also think, you know, if you try to take, you know, your imaginary lenses off and put his imaginary lenses on, that you'd be able to really see from his perspective.
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense, and I'll be sure to do that. Thanks, Coach.
Hey, Jack. Hey, Ben. I talked to you both, and now I think it's a good time to resolve this tiff between you guys and get some compromise and clarity. I've listened to how you both feel, and I see there's been a little bit of miscommunication between the two of you. I'd like for you guys to collaborate about why you guys are upset so you guys can critically analyze your emotions and make a solution and possibly transformation.
Well, I mean, Ben, you're my best friend, but lately I've been feeling upset because you don't really care about how your actions affect me. I'm always your wingman for you and do whatever I can to be a good friend, but lately I've been wondering why you don't do the same for me. The one time I tell you I'm interested in a girl, instead of supporting me, you make it a competition. Ever since we came back from spring break, it seems like you just want to show off your superiority to me.
I'm really sorry. You know, during our time apart, I acknowledged that I shouldn't have made you know, Stacey a competition. And I understand how I haven't been a fair friend to you the past couple months. From my point of view, it seemed like you didn't have a problem with being my wingman. You know, like I kind of thought that was like our dynamic. You've never said anything otherwise. And when I think you're upset and ask what's wrong, you brush me off and say nothing. So I usually just drop it. I assume you'll come and talk to me about it when you're ready. I need you to be more transparent with me so that I know when I'm upsetting you.
I think this conflict is an opportunity for you guys to better your friendship. Remember, it's not what you say, it's how you say it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sorry I haven't been communicating with you about my frustrations. I'll work on being clear about my emotions and being more honest with you.
Yeah, and I mean, I get so competitive and sometimes and try too hard to be the best, but I see how it affects you and probably other people around me too. I'll try and be more aware and accountable for how my actions affect you. Want to come to my place after school? I got nachos.
Dude, I'm happy we found a way to transform our friendship into an even better one. Heck yeah, I want to come over. I love freaking nachos.
Yeah.
Better save some for me and bring some to practice.
Got you, coach.
Yeah. Thanks.